Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Well, now the Lord has spoken with me. The Lord Jehovah, He spoke with me this past night. And the Lord has spoken with me about the grand mega historic end of year revival that is coming to Kisumu. And in this conversation, the Lord has shown me the massive unseen visitation that is coming to Kisumu. Again, this past night, the Lord Jehovah Elohim, the eternal creator of the universe and the heavens, Jehovah, the Lord, our maker, Hoseinu, Jehovah El Shalom, Jehovah El Sabaoth, the Lord of hosts, the Lord, He has spoken with me about this very, very mega, never seen before, historic revival that is coming up to Kisumu. And I am very, very surprised by this type of visitation, because I see many, many, many cripples that begin to get up and walk. The anointing will be tremendous, will be unmatched, unparalleled, unseen before. I see this young girl, she has raised her hair, she combed her hair, raised, light skin, was totally crippled, gets up and walks. And I see, and she's probably around, are we talking 12, maybe 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, around that age. And, I see a boy of similar age also, totally crippled. And I see that the left leg had been crippled and swollen. I think it was just like flesh. It was swollen. The left leg was swollen right before the ankle, and was weak, swollen, a little distended and weak. And then the Lord strengthened his legs, and he begins to walk for the first time, totally crippled. And I see many, many other cripples, the crippled babies, the young ones that will begin to walk. They will begin to stand up for the first time and make their first steps on this earth, walking toward the Lord. And I see mature people that were born crippled that have never walked, also getting up and walking, and then middle-aged people. So this has been a major, major conversation about the meeting that is coming up in Kisumu. The Lord has decided at this moment in time to visit and restore His church, to make a very huge visitation, a visitation that has not been seen on this earth before. And the Lord Jehovah is saying that He is coming in the massive of all massive power. He is coming to restore the church. He's coming to love the church, to establish her, to heal her. He's coming to strengthen her feet, that she may walk and she may go. Yeah? She may go now unto the mission of the Lord, that she may bear a testimony at this very critical hour in the history of the life of the church on this earth. And I see very, very many blind eyes that are going to pop open, babies that are very young and blind, babies that are now coming to the age of 3, 4, also blind, the eyes are open, the deaf, the mute, I see mature blind people also, the eyes opened, and then the deaf will hear in their largest number. This meeting, in this conversation that the Lord had with me this past night, The visitation of the holy anointing of the Lord, the flow of the glory of the Lord, as the man of God, the mighty prophet, his servant, walks into the stadium, walked into the field, the grounds of the meeting, the flow of the anointing of the glory of the Lord is going to be so humongous it will overwhelm every living being that is on this earth that will set their ears or their eyes on this. Now I have understood that this is the meeting that nobody on the face of this earth, nobody created by Jehovah, who was created by the God of Israel, the omnipotent creator, Jehovah El Mekadishken, the Lord our sanctifier, Jehovah Eloheinu, Jehovah El Gibor, nobody created by this mighty God, Jehovah El Jireh, can ever afford, to miss this meeting. Now I have understood, because this is going to be a meeting like none ever, never ever seen before. Because as the Lord will bring his mighty servant, as he brings him right at the entrance into the grounds of the meeting, the most unspoken anointing of the Lord will fall from heaven, and it will be overwhelming. In this conversation this night, the Lord has shown me that this will overrun us, will be literally overrun by the massive healing anointing that will fall, the glory that will fall there, and is going to baptize people. Many, many, many creatures are going to walk. It's going to stand the eyes of any creation that has been created by the Lord on this earth. It's going to stand the eyes of creation to see the number of cripples, how they're going to walk. Very many cripples will get up and walk, because this is the hour for them to get up. The waiting is over now. The Lord has also shown me in this conversation that many, 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 many blind eyes will open, blind babies, blind children, boys and girls, mature people, women and men, born properly blind for all their lives. For once they will now see for the first time, many blind eyes will open, many, many, many deaf ears will pop up and they will hear very clearly. And the ears, I have seen the ears very sensitive. The ears become extremely, very, very sensitive. They cannot stand the sound of the public address system. So many, many, in the largest number ever, ever, there will be huge bulk. The Lord is going to give them in batches, in groups, in bulk. Many, many deaf ears, the healing anointing that the Lord has now brought forth at this hour into the life of his servant is now heavenly. It's a heavenly anointing that is going to visit that ground. Because I see the number of healing of the deaf I've never seen before, which means finally their cry has revived. The Lord, Jehovah El Adonai, Jehovah El Sibikenu, Jehovah El Gibor, El Shama, Jehovah Eloheka. The Lord is now saying that their waiting is over. They are waiting, if they have been waiting that they may walk as cripples, that waiting is over because of the hour. The clock now, the clock in heaven has shifted now, and we are sitting on the verge of eternity, and this is the hour when the demonstration of the power of the blood of the cross of Jesus must come to bear, must come to bear on this earth. But Jesus must be feared now. That the blood of Jesus must be defended now by this servant. That the power of the anointing of the cross must now be defended at this hour. That everybody know that there is no other power on this earth and in heaven that is higher than Jesus. The power of the Messiah. The power of the blood. I see many, many, many cripples healed as the Lord brings his mighty servant to the field, and many blind eyes opened. Many deaf ears opened, and they're very sensitive. Many tongues that were mute, loosened, and many limb legs stretched and strengthened. I see them walking about in crutches and wheelchairs. Many paralytics are going to get up and walk and celebrate the goodness of the Lord. Many broken backs, many spinal cord injuries, bleeding diseases, wounds, many types of
internal organs, the kidney, the liver, the spleen, the blood, the heart, or many conditions will be healed. There will be massive outpour of the glory of the Lord when the Lord brings his mighty servant into this tremendous historic meeting of this time, the meeting of our life. Remember, it is the same Kisumu, the same ground at which the massive cloud of Jehovah, the cloud of Moses, the cloud of the God of Moses came down and visited his servant there. So this is going to be yet another moment when the Lord is going to make a bold move and do what has not been spoken before, what has not been seen before, what has not been heard before, because of the hour in which we live. This is the hour of righteousness. This is the hour of holiness. This is the hour of preparing for the coming of the Messiah. The Lord is going to do creation. He's going to create many things on the people to establish the power of the blood of Jesus, the power of the cross at Calvary. He will establish it without a doubt. He will establish it with extreme power. He will ensure that the blood of Jesus is finally descended again. He has sent forth a fiery messenger to defend the cross, to defend the Messiah, to defend the blood of Jesus again. And restore the church. And announce the coming of the Messiah, the King of Israel, the King of Kings, the King of Jerusalem. Many years, the pastors of corruption have gone around with women. They have taken money. They have spoken money. They have corrupted their lives. And the blood and the cross has been diminished, has been radished, has been extinguished. But now he sends a fiery one to restore, to defend the Messiah again. Defend the blood, defend the cross, defend the church, defend the Messiah. He is coming. I have seen the fire of the Messiah. I've seen his glory coming. I see the glory of the Messiah coming. I see him coming. I see him coming.